Hello guys, welcome back with me, Chocho 2025. Today we're going to talk about math, string split, and if conditioned for math in Comfyui UI. Here are a list of node that could help you do math and string split. The first one is simple math. To install it, simply open manager. Click custom node manager and search for simple math. Install simple math from Cubic. Restart Comfy when you were asked to. Or you could also install custom script from Python Gosses. Simple math will give you simple math node and custom script will give you math expression. With math expression, you could also do if logic comparison. You could install custom script the same way you installed simple math. Honestly, I prefer the custom node script math expression better, so we will focus on them. Here are a few examples using primitive integer node. We show multiplication on simple math and a simple add in math expression. We use show any to show the result. Here are the result. Now, we could actually use the output of our math to another math expression. We will use seal function to round up our result, and then we use the integer result. Also here the detail function of the node. Other node's values can be referenced via the node name for SNR via the properties menu item on a node, or the node title. Supported operators plus, minus, asterisks or multiplication and divide for basic ops. Double slash is for floor division. Double asterisks for power. The freestanding circumflex for x or operation. And percentage for mod or reminder. It also supported functions like floor for number and dp, floor for number only. Seal for number only and randomint for min and max. If using a latient or imagg, you can get the dimensions using a width or a height where is the input name. Also, we could also use condition of IIF, a conditional function. Also, we could use many other function. Here a print screen of operator and function. Here a bunch of example. Now let's try to find its use when design a workflow. For example, we want to interpolate a video, so we make sure the audio will be multiplication by the interpolate setting. Here an example. First, we need to be able to extract frame count and force rate. Frame count itself is very easy, since it will simply take from the output. For force rate, we need some trick because we can extract this from video info. But we need string manipulation to be able to extract the value. First, let's see what video info value is. It is a bunch of information about the video and our setting of the node. So let's use string split from Comfyui various. The first step is to split the left part. After that, the right part. Then we need to convert it to string to float so we can use the number. So we now only need to set one thing only every time we want to change the multiplier RIFE VPI. Another example, if we want to use Meta Batch Manager. If we use Meta Batch Manager and interpolate it, we need to make sure that the last batch is more than one frame, or else error will be generated. The trick here, if the last batch has one frame, we should simply ignore it. So we're going to do conditional and check whether the last frame is one frame or not with mod operation. And if it is one, then we simply cap the frame of frame count minus one. Else we're going to use frame cap as the frame count. Here is the example. Anyway, guys, that's it for today's video. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and comment. See you again on the next episode. And have a nice day. Please subscribe.